You all, we've had it all wrong. Notion is not a productivity tool. And in this video, I want to talk about why that is and why reframing our perspective on what Notion is can help us better understand the platform and other tools like it, as well as actually make it a tool for us to be more productive. And yes, there is a difference. So let's go ahead and talk about it. Now, when Notion came onto the market quite a few years back, it's understandable for us to have perceived it as just another productivity tool. We had to liken it to something like Evernote or Trello or Asana or any of these other platforms that were around at the time, because that's mostly where it fit in at that time. But as we've begun to see over the years, they start to add additional features, new blocks, new elements, and the complexity of the tool continues to increase. I've seen and I've heard frustrations from many about using Notion because their perspective is like, well, it's not particularly making my job easier. The complexities to interact with the platform were higher than they were anticipating, right? Those hurdles, the barriers to entry were increasing as the program and the platform started to evolve. Now, yes, there were some UX UI challenges earlier on that just weren't there yet that they have solved moving forward with some later updates. Yet at the same time, those qualms about the complexities remain, and rightfully so when people are still looking at it as a productivity tool. Here is why I say Notion is not a productivity tool. If you look at the Notion motto, and if you've heard it, you'll see that their mission is to make software tool making ubiquitous. That absolutely underscores the whole premise of why Notion is far more complex than what people might have initially interpreted it to be. Their mission is far grander than just being some productivity solution. Rather, we should be looking at Notion as a platform to build our own systems. And it's entirely upon us whether those systems are productive, whether the structure of those systems that we develop hinder or enhance our productivity. Now, another major philosophy that Notion has been strongly representing with their brand since the beginning is this idea that Notion and the elements and the tools within it are very much similar to digital Lego blocks. And their entire conference is referred to as block by block. I feel justified to presume that that is more than just a conference name. Block by block is a philosophy or an approach that they're actually taking to the ways in which they are introducing us to deeper levels of programmatic thinking. And actually, if you're interested on more of that particular topic, I ended up writing an article about how I just wanted to be a productive artist and somehow Notion led me to programmatic thinking. I'm sure there's quite a few of us who have had a similar journey. So if that interests you, go ahead and check out that article, which I happen to write on a Web3 based platform called paragraph.xyz. But I'll leave the link down in the description or in the comment section below. Oh, and before I forget, if you're enjoying the contents of this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more content like this. And leave some feedback if you will. A comment with saying, hey, this was a helpful video, or hey, I would like to hear more about this or that. It goes a long way. So thank you for tuning in, and back to the rest of the content. Block by block is a philosophy or an approach that they're actually taking to the ways in which they are introducing us to deeper levels of programmatic thinking. If their overall motto and objective is to make software tool making ubiquitous, one thing that I'm seeing is that they're doing their due diligence to introduce things in a very incremental fashion. I think they are being very mindful about giving just enough of the tools, of the blocks, of the elements to let people play and to create something new and to experience what it is that they're offering without throwing the entire sink at us. That decision for things to be introduced block by block, one thing at a time, very deliberately, and rolling out in such a way that is reducing the amount of friction that we might have with too many new features all at once. I think that's a very deliberate decision because not everyone is a power user. Most people on the internet today are still, by and large, you know, just interacting with it in a way that feels comfortable to them. It's the few and far between that are actually the power users, that are diving into the nuances of every platform, that are looking into the docs, that are actually communicating with different devs and their startups and their platforms via Slack channels or Discord servers. So I do believe that Notion is mindful of this, and to achieve their goal of making software toolmaking ubiquitous, they have to also spoon feed, in a way, the broader tech consumer base to some of these more advanced concepts that each one of their blocks or their elements introduces to developing out a system or a workflow. And so with that philosophy in mind, things start to make more sense to me about how Notion is positioning themselves, as well as why we should interpret it differently when it comes to them just being a productivity tool. And since the company mission seems heavily focused on that objective, to make software toolmaking ubiquitous, the broadest scope of their efforts would be into providing each one of those blocks or those different pieces to give us the tool set that we need to create these robust systems, while at the same time leaving it mostly upon us as the users of their platform to discover what it means to create a system or a solution for ourselves, whatever our personal or professional endeavors are, to commune with one another as a community base, to share the ideas and the concepts that we have explored and built using this particular tool. Sure, they have released a few templates that provide out-of-the-box solutions, and that's meaningful for those who are likely pushing for those kinds of solutions directly from the Notion team. But by and large, you can tell they leave a lot of the support and the ingenuity and the solution creating to the community base. And that's why Notion has a rather thriving creator economy, with many out there like myself who provide solutions based on our configurations, which allows us to really begin diving into that programmatic thinking and giving us the autonomy to start building out solutions to our own professional and personal endeavors that don't particularly rely on a bunch of different third-party platforms and solutions to cover every single nuance of our business or our endeavors. So that's why I feel it's important for us to not look at Notion as a productivity tool, but rather as a platform that allows us to build productive systems for ourselves and for one another. So I hope that brings a bit of clarity to what the platform is, and maybe that's something that has released a bit of tension for you, or maybe those frustrations that you might have felt about why Notion felt one way versus another. And with this newfound clarity, start approaching it with that open-mindedness of creating something new. I had this saying at once that I felt very strongly about when it came to feeling frustrated about not finding the exact solutions for my business processes as a creative entrepreneur in any other platform. And that is, before you can trust the process, you must design the process. And at the very least, if you're not designing the process, you have to absolutely get behind the mind of the one who is designing that process. And that's why I feel strongly about whenever I release a template that I'm actually doing some overview or walkthrough of my mindset, the philosophy behind my approach to why I built things a certain way or not. And consequently, because of that, it does take me a bit more time to roll out new templates, because I want to be more intentional about making sure that when I do, it's accompanied by the video overview, the actual walkthrough or the guide that will help you to understand the approach behind it, so that you can actually take advantage of that template as if it was your own system. So I say all that to say, with newfound perspective, let's approach not just Notion, but any other tool like it that came after it or that has positioned itself as a competitor to the Notion platform. Notion, Obsidian, Tana, Trello, Capacities, any type, which I kind of like. Any of these tools, we should be approaching with that philosophy in mind. It's not particularly their mission to create an out-of-the-box productive solution for our endeavors. Rather, they are providing us with a suite of tools, of elements, blocks, functions, all of these different things that we can then take to design and structure our own productive solutions. So that's that on that. Yes, the new Music OS Plus template will be on the way very soon, I promise. And I will certainly make sure that it's accompanied by the visual overview, additional video guides talking about that system and how it can actually provide you with a meaningful, productive system for your musical endeavors. Likewise, I'll have a couple of other templates down the pipeline released as well, and I'll be working on those videos to accompany those. Some are niche community things and others are a bit broader perspective, but hopefully they provide you all with meaningful solutions that improve your productivity, because that's what we're here for, right? The creator economy that surrounds these various platforms. Now, you might be wondering as well, hey, I've already got your previous template and now you're saying there's gonna be an upgraded version of that. If you're feeling any anxiety around that, thinking, hey, how am I gonna get my existing data into that new template structure? Don't worry, I have the perfect video for you explaining how to do database migrations when it comes to full Notion template systems. So go ahead and check that out. I'll link it up above or somewhere in the description or comments below or at the end card, you know, wherever that is. And yeah, we'll get to it. We'll see you on the next one. All right. Peace and blessings. Peace and blessings.